One way to understand evolution is to consider how local populations begin to differentiate. In other words, how does evolution actually work? Fortunately, we have a pretty good understanding of the fundamental forces or mechanisms of evolution. Most of you have heard of one of those forces, the force popularized by Charles Darwin. Without any knowledge of genetics, Darwin realized that, one, in the struggle for survival, not everyone reproduces, and two, heritable traits that improve your chances of having offspring will greater the odds of perpetuating in the next generation. This mechanism of evolution is known as natural selection. We now understand much more about genetics and how traits can change within a local population over time. The study of this process is called population genetics, and in population genetics, the term evolution is given a very practical definition. Evolution refers to the change in the frequencies of the alleles, or genetic types, over time within a population of interbreeding individuals. In population genetics, natural selection remains a fundamental mechanism of evolution, but it's certainly not alone. Boiled down, there are essentially four forces or mechanisms of evolution. The first, genetic drift, which is the change in allele frequencies that occur from the random aspect of mating and creating the next generation. Next is mutation, which is the initial origin of any new allele. Third is natural selection, which refers to the allele's impact on reproductive success with respect to the environment. Fourth is gene flow, or gene migration, the movement of alleles between populations. Let's talk about these forces a little more.